I'm Dick Clark, and welcome to our weekly countdown of the most popular songs in the land.
Dick Clark's National Music Survey.
As we count down the most listened to songs of the week, we'll also get a behind-the-scenes peek at the music industry in exclusive comments with some of your favorite stars. And we get underway with a recap of the top three songs on last week's chart. At number three a week ago, Steve Perry and Foolish Heart.
I need a love that grows. I don't want it unless I know that it's passing on. Someone somehow will be there, ready to share. I need a love that's strong. I'm so tired of being alone, but will the fool again.
Steve Perry holding on at number three last week for the second week in a row with Foolish Heart, and one step ahead of Steve with the second most popular song on last week's survey was Foreigner, I Want to Know What Love Is.
I've got to take a little time, a little time to think things over. I better read between the lines, in case I need it when I'm older. Now this mountain I must climb feels like the world upon my shoulder. Through the clouds I see love. Keeps me warm as life grows colder. In my life, there's been heartache and pain.
1 week ago, Foreigner had the number two song in the land with I Want to Know What Love Is, and sitting on top of our survey a week ago for the third week in a row, the first number one song by Wham, Careless Whisper.
Thank you.
Careless Whisper, Wham, last week's number one song, and they'll be trying to make it one more week in a row, sitting on top of the survey. Could be a tight race. That's our instant recap of the top three songs from one week ago. The National Music Survey is presented by the Mutual Radio Network, compiled from a reporting network of more than 200 radio stations, based on the Adult Contemporary Music Chart, compiled by Radio and Records, the industry trade publication. And brought to you in part by Norcliffe Thayer, the makers of OxyLine Acne Products, a new OxyClean Cleanser. Now, just ahead, we're going to count down the most listened to songs in the land as we work our way up to the number one song of the week.
Next time your stomach talks to you, you'd better listen.
Hot dogs.
Oops.
Armor hot dogs.
Who's that?
Why don't you send down an Armor hot dog?
It's my stomach.
They're so filling and they're lots of fun.
I know.
It'd be thrilling if you'd send down another one.
Okay. Hot dogs. Armor hot dogs.
Oh, that's good. The dogs kids love to bite.
Aren't your kids?
America's kids. No toothpaste is doing more to help them get their best checkups than Crest.
Aren't your kids?
Every year, Crest prevents more kids' cavities than any other toothpaste.
Aren't your kids?
So when it comes to getting great checkups, aren't your kids worth Crest?
Aren't your kids the best?
Mommy, Mommy, my checkup guess
what? Aren't your kids worth Crest?
You're listening to the National Music Survey, our weekly review of the most popular songs in the country, and our family of stations includes KY98 St. Louis, Missouri, WRBN, Rock 102, Warner Robins, Georgia, 123 Kissin, Coos Bay, Oregon, and WMAS FM 95, Springfield, Massachusetts. You know, they say opposites often make the most interesting combinations, and that's certainly true in the case of this next record. Sharing a duet on this song is one woman known for one of the purest, smoothest voices in pop history, and another woman known for a distinctive, sort of gravelly voice, often compared with Rod Stewart. And together, they are pure gold. In the eighth week here on the National Music Survey, we've got Barbra Streisand, Kim Carnes, and Make No Mistake, He's Mine, in the number 25 position.
He's mine, he's mine.
Barbra Streisand teaming up with Kim Carnes on a former top 10 hit, Make No Mistake, He's Mine, holding the number 25 spot on our countdown. I'm Dick Clark on the National Music Survey, and it was all the way back in May of last year when this next superstar made her last appearance on the survey. The song was a remake of the old Petula Clark hit Downtown, and this weekend she returns with the first single from her brand new album. This is Dolly, Dolly Parton, with a debut song, Don't Call It Love. It's number 24 on the survey this week. Debuting this weekend with a single from her brand new Real Love album, that's Dolly Parton with Don't Call It Love. On the survey at number 24 this weekend. Just ahead, more of the biggest hits of the week as we count down the most popular songs in the land.
Dick Clark's National Music Survey.
You're welcome anytime, anywhere you'll find a smile. You've got Visa. Visa is all you need.
Visa says so much. Visa says you're in touch
with all that life has to give and the way you want to live.
It's all you need, Visa.
Visa is all you need.
It's all you
around the world, Visa is all you need.
It's all you need, Visa.
I'm Ed McMahon. I'd like to remind you that another edition of TV's Bloopers and Practical Jokes will be coming your way this Monday night on NBC. Dick Clark and I will be showing you some of the funniest bloopers that have ever occurred in front of a camera, from the stars of the golden age of live television to your local anchorman. We will prove once again that nobody's perfect. And of course, our Practical Joke crew has been busy at work catching some of your favorite stars completely off guard. And that's not all. We'll also have a potpourri of entertaining features, like the crazy world of sports bloopers, classic commercials, visits to the streets of New York and Hollywood, and as always, some special surprises. So tune in my pal, Dick Clark, and me every Monday night on TV's Bloopers and Practical Jokes, 8 o'clock, 7 o'clock Central Time. Let's all be there.